Hey guys, Real Doctor Jin here, board certified internal medicine doctor. Today, I'm going to show you something fun. I have got this one. DGIOM4. I'm not going to sell you this machine, but I'm going to shoot my video today with DGIOM4. With DGIOM4, let's shake to the left, shake to the right, shake forward, and shake backwards. That's fun. And today we are going to watch a very interesting and up-to-date TikTok show. Let's take a look.
What's going on, guys? I am currently COVID positive and I can't taste anything. Everyone keeps telling me to try and eat like some nasty stuff, but I don't have any nasty stuff in my house.
He's so I figured I'd just like
eat some stuff that would be strong or pungent or something, you know, just to see what it's like. So here's an onion.
Wow, he's eating the onion like eating an apple. That's interesting, but I believe he can taste nothing. Let's continue watch.
Nothing.
Shot of lemon juice.
Lemon juice, sour, very sour.
Nothing.
And garlic paste? Oh, that would hurt. Nothing.
Look at the face.
This is a crazy virus. Check out this painting.
Look at that. He's tasting very spicy onion and sour lemonade, but he tastes nothing. What happened? Basically, some patient who got positive for the coronavirus, they lost their taste. Let's review a little bit about the taste. For the taste, it's not a regular question during the clinic encounter. In very few cases, we ask a patient about the taste. Now, since we have the pandemic here, and this becomes a very common question during the encounter.
Ooh.
Since it's become common now, let's go back to elementary school and to know a little bit more about the taste. How many tastes do we have? Leave a comment below.
And there are at least 5 main flavors that your tongue can taste. Sweet, sour, salty, bitter, and umami.
Umami, that's my favorite, umami. I like sushi, sashimi, and that's umami. What's your favorite taste? Sweet, salty, sour? I don't think you like bitter. And how about umami? If you did a very good job in the elementary school, you may know this different taste located in the different areas of the tongue. Is that true?
You're probably familiar with those taste maps of your tongue from elementary school. Well, unfamiliarize yourself because they are bogus. Those tongue diagrams date back to the early 1900s when German scientist D.P. Hanig tried to measure the sensitivity of different areas for salty, sweet, sour, and bitter. The resulting map was very subjective, pretty much just reflecting what his volunteers felt like they were sensing.
So this taste map is inaccurate. That's the old knowledge. Clinically, we called loss of taste dysgeusia. Dys means the function is not right, and geusia means the taste. That means the function of the taste is not right. If the taste totally lost, we call it ageusia, and if it's partially lost, we call it hypogeusia. Do we have medications that cause this dysgeusia? Yes, we do. Some antihistamine medication can cause dysgeusia. There is a special antihistamine medication can cause loss of the taste, ezelastin. Usually we use this antihistamine for the eyes, for itchiness, and for the nose to reduce the nasal congestion. Is there any other clinical situation which causing the loss of taste? Yes, we do. I have a list for you here. chemotherapy, asthma patient treated with albuterol, zinc deficiency, some severe hypothyroidism, and some special kind of seizure. So if you lost off your taste, it's not 100% of coronavirus infection.
Ooh.
But in this pandemic situation, if you develop loss of smell or taste, please check and schedule for COVID-19 testing. If you are unfortunately got infected with coronavirus and you are the one who lost off the taste, you can try different ways to monitor your recovery of the taste. If you like this video, please click subscribe, hit the bell, and every Friday I will meet you and watch Grey's Anatomy with you. We are now on episode 8. You can catch up with us. In this pandemic season, you can watch more videos.